Hi, I'm Rudolf Hacken, viola professor at the University of Illinois. Today, we'll be going over one of the most commonly requested viola excerpts, Strauss's Don Juan. You may have noticed I'm playing a five-string viola. However, to avoid confusion, I won't be using the E string in this video. If you'd like a PDF of Don Juan with my fingerings, the link is in the video description below. I should mention that for this video, we'll be tuning at A440. Let's start with measure one. We'll play the last note, then the last three notes, last five notes, and so forth. We'll play at half tempo for now. Take the same approach to measures 35 and 36. I'll start by playing the passage for you as written. First, let's establish fingerings. Middle of bar 35, I'm in fifth position for five notes. Then I shift up to seventh position for the last four notes. Keep in mind, when you play up in seventh position, it takes much less left finger pressure to get the pitches to sound, and your bowing needs to be light to avoid distorting the pitch and tone. Now we'll play the last note of this passage, then the last two notes, and so forth. Let's play the second half of measure 35, leaving out individual notes. That way, in an audition, you can miss a note without having it completely throw you off. Thank you. Now let's play measures 35 and 36 together as written. Let's take the same approach to measure 33. First, we'll play it as written. Now let's leave out individual notes from each beat. Now I'll play measures 33 through 36 for you as written. Now let's play measures 33 through 36, just the first note of each quarter. Here are measures 23 through 24 as written. Now we'll eliminate individual notes from this passage. Now we'll play measures 23 through 24 once again, as written. Now here's measure 4 as written. I play the first half of the bar in 4th position, and the second half in 5th position. Since we're playing at half speed, we can break up the bowings. Now let's play measures 4 and 5, omitting individual notes. Now let's play measures 4 and 5 as written. When you look at a difficult passage, there are usually several aspects to make it tricky to play. Bow strokes, finger patterns, string changes, rhythm, and so forth. It's good to concentrate on specific elements when you practice. Let's play measure 6 as written. Now we'll play measure 6 with all the fingerings as they should be, but move them all to one string. That way we can get our left fingers moving correctly without worrying about string changes. Thank you. let's play measure 6 as written. Now let's look at measures 52 to 53. Here you have shifting, intonation, dynamics, and bow strokes, all competing for your attention. One way to separate these tasks in a passage is to shift-chikify it, meaning that you create short, bite-sized exercises in the style of Ottokar Shevchik. Let's make a repetitious exercise starting on the fourth pitch of this passage. Let's start on the fifth pitch. Now let's start on the sixth pitch. Now let's concentrate on bowing for measures 52 and 53. Let's start by playing as written. Now just the first three notes. Now the first three notes, but on open A. Going from a forte to a piano, all with a clean bounce, requires a very relaxed right hand. Now let's play the whole passage on open strings. Now let's play measures 52 and 53 again as written. Another challenge here is to switch from spiccato to legato and then add hairpins. It's important to follow articulations precisely. Pay attention to staccato versus legato, long versus short notes, and so forth. Let's look at measures 21 and 22 as an example. The word square at the start means you move from the C string to the G with an angular stroke. Now let's play each of these bow strokes with rests between them. And now let's play the whole excerpt. We're going to do this twice, once at a practice tempo of 110, then up to tempo at 164. Thank you. now up to tempo at 164. Thanks for tackling Don Juan with me. Hope this was useful. And please contact me with questions, comments, ideas, or your own rendition of Don Juan. I'd love to hear from you.